this way.
Thank you.
morning.
Good morning.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
We give God thanks and praise for another day. We thank God that God is here with us and among us. We welcome you to the service today. We welcome those online who are watching and those who are here. We welcome you to this day of worship. And now, friends, we are not going to announce this, so let us now hear the preacher.
Amen.
And now we hear my faith.
praying for people's lives. Patient Lord, our hearts seem to buckle under the weight of worries and confusion, and we turn away from you. Please forgive us. Help us to learn that you are actively involved in our lives. Help us to place our trust in you, so that when we are serving others, they may come to know your abiding love and power. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Too many, because God saw the hearts of those who were there. God in here. And so we do the ones that people tend to know and check it out and things like that. There are 12 of them. And those 12 judges ruled Israel during different times because the people needed a leader over them. But God would equip all those leaders in his own unique way, according to their gifts and skills, to do what thus saith the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
So boys and girls, you can hold on to God and know that when the Lord calls you, he's going to be with you, he's going to lead you and bring you through. Thanks be to God. Amen?
Amen.
So that's the story of Gideon. Remember now, Gideon and the 300 men. Amen. And I come to man, when I test your this, you know now. Maybe it'll be a pretty good one. And now we will have the next reading, I guess.
Please stand for the prayer for illumination. Let us pray together. Lord, upon the hope of our hearts and minds, by the power of your Holy Spirit, that as the scriptures are read and your word proclaimed, we may hear with joy what you say to us today. Amen. Please be seated. The Old Testament reading for today is 1 Samuel chapter 8, verses 4 through 20, which can be found in the Old Testament. Then all the elders of Israel gathered together and came to Samuel at Ramah and said to him, "You are old, and your sons do not follow in your ways. Appoint for us then a king to govern us like other nations." But the thing displeased Samuel when they said, "Give us a king to govern us." Samuel prayed to the Lord, and the Lord said to Samuel, "Listen to the voice of the people in all that they say to you, for they have not rejected you, but they have rejected me from being king over them. Just as they have done to me from the day I brought them up out of Egypt to this day, forsaking me and serving other gods, so also they are doing to you. Now then, listen to their voice. Only you shall solemnly warn them and show them the ways of the king who shall reign over them." So Samuel reported all the words of the Lord to the people who were asking him for a king. He said, "These will be the ways of the king who will reign over you. He will take your sons and appoint them to his chariots and to be his horsemen and to run before his chariots. And he will appoint for himself commanders of thousands and commanders of fifties, and some to plow his ground and to reap his harvest, and to make his implements of war and the equipment of his chariots. He will change your daughters to be perfumers and cooks and bakers. He will take the best of your fields and vineyards and olive orchards and give them to his courtiers. He will take 1/10 of your grain and of your vineyards and give it to his officers and his courtiers. He will take your male and female slaves and the best of your cattle and donkeys and put them to his work. He will take 1/10 of your flocks, and you shall be his slaves. And in that day you will cry out because of your king, whom you have chosen for yourselves. But the Lord will not answer you in that day." But the people refused to listen to the voice of Samuel. They said, "No, but we are determined to have a king over us, so that we also may be like other nations, and that our king may govern us and go out before us and fight our battles." This ends the Old Testament reading.
came together again so that they could not even eat. When his family heard it, they went out to restrain him. For people were saying, he has gone out of his mind. And the scribes who came down from Jerusalem and said, he has Beelzebul, and by the ruler of the demon he cast out demons. And he called them to him and spoke to them in parables. How can Satan cast out Satan? If a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom cannot stand. And if a house is divided against itself, that house will not be able to stand. And if Satan has risen up against himself and is divided, he cannot stand, but his end has come. But no one can enter the strong man's house and plunder his property without first tying up the strong man. Then indeed the house can be plundered. Truly I tell you, people will be forgiven for their sins and whatever blasphemies they utter. But whoever blasphemies against the Holy Spirit can never be forgiven, but is guilty of the eternal sin. For they have said, he has unclean spirit. Then his mother and his brothers came, and standing outside, they sent to him and called him. A crowd was sitting around them, and they said to him, your mother and your brothers and your sisters are outside, asking for you. And he replied, who are my mother and my brothers? And looking at those who sat around him, he said, here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does the will of God is my brother and sister and mother. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thank you, God.
Let us pray. Loving and gracious God, we thank you. We thank you for your loving kindness and for your tender mercies. We thank you for Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We thank you, Lord God, that you're with us here today. Speak now, Lord God, by your Holy Spirit. Speak because we're listening. Speak a word for us, for your people. Speak, Lord God. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of all of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, because you are our refuge and our strength. You are our Savior and our Lord. Amen. Now my sermon title today is United in Mission and Ministry. Let me clean my glasses. 1 minute. Ministers provide a very different function.
bodies, you know, also. But I'm focusing on the church, right? But you can take that, you're in a house and it's divided. Jesus, the Bible tells us that the crowd had come together again so that they, and they would not let them eat. Would not let Jesus and the disciples eat, right? And when his family heard it, they went to restrain him, for the people were saying, he is gone out of his mind. Even Jesus' family did not understand his mission. Right? One writer says, if you think you have any family problems in your family, just look at Jesus' family. They did not get it, right? They thought he was crazy. And the scribes who came down from Jerusalem said, he was the devil, right? Right? He was from the devil. And that he was the ruler over the demons, because he cast demons out. So they were demonizing him. They didn't understand his mission. And so he called them to him, Jesus did, and he spoke to them in parables. And he said, how can Satan cast out Satan? And then he said, if a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom cannot stand. Friends, if a church is divided against itself, it cannot stand. And then Jesus would say, and if a house is divided against itself, that house will not stand. And if Satan has risen up against himself and is divided, he cannot stand when his end will come. So Jesus is saying even Satan cannot be divided against himself. Amazing, isn't it? That we as church must always seek to understand the mission. And I want to tell church members, it is more productive and certainly more Christian to work along with the leadership of the church, starting with the pastor, making comments, good constructive comments, than going behind the leadership's back and you love the people here that do that, talking to the other people who are missing. Are you all listening? Right, that going behind and trying to critique and judge things that we don't understand, because what it does, it brings a divided church. Amen? Scripture said we should be on one accord. Right? Sunday morning, when you see us here Sunday morning or see me, this is just one small percentage of what goes on here to get to you. Right? This is what you see. This is what people see online. But this is only one small percentage. All week long, we are working together, working the team to figure out what we must do to get it look so seamless to the best of our ability. Amen? And sometimes we mess up because we are what? Human beings. Right? Scripture says, is anyone without sin cast the first stone? So I try to say to people, don't waste your energy and your breath. Now, I know Doug is here. Doug has been coming to church now because he's watching the mics. And I finally said to Doug, my God, I'm here again. Because he has been here all week, not to pick on him, just to try to figure out every day, sometimes at night, he's calling me in the morning. He's here trying to get the technology, which is more complicated than we think, getting it going, even on my computers and missing computer, and things are down, and getting the internet up, and all kinds of things, and the cameras, and this has changed. It is all week long trying to get it looking right for today. Right? For the one day that we come, but more than that, to glorify God. Right? So that someone could hear the gospel. that instantly reminded them of the manna of the Old Testament. And looking closer, they discovered the lawn was filled with mushrooms of the very best quality, which was quite mysterious because it wasn't the season for mushrooms. And gathering the crop, the clerks carted the mushrooms down the street and sold them to the chef of the Palmer House, the famed hotel just off Richmond Avenue, for a large price. Amen?
Amen.
And the receipts were enough to pay the rent, with enough left over to meet other ministry expenses. So the Pacific Garden Mission carried on its work undeterred. Amen?
Amen.
When you work together for the good of God's people and you trust God, God will bring you through. This was a problem for the children of Israel in that Old Testament text I was read to you. What they God was for the children of Israel throughout the beginning of the Bible, from Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, you see God in their midst, right? We get to 1 Samuel, and they're watching everybody else's ministry, so to speak. They're watching all the nation, and they now want what? A king. They became a group divided. It says the reading said that all the elders of Israel gathered together and came to Samuel at Ramah and said to him, "You are old and your sons do not follow in your ways. Appoint us then a king to govern us." But the thing displeased Samuel when they said, "Give us a king to govern us." And Samuel prayed to God. Pray to the Lord, and the Lord said to Samuel, "Listen to the voice of the people in that they say to you, what they say to you. If they have not rejected you, Samuel, but they have rejected me. They have rejected God asking for a king. Just as they have done to me from the day I brought them out of Egypt to this day, forsaking me and serving other gods, so also they are doing to you. Now listen to their voice only, and you shall solemnly warn them." And so there is Samuel warning them. He's telling them, if you are divided and you seek to leave God and want a king, all these things are going to happen to your people. They're going to become slaves. They're going to be treated badly. They're going to prostitute them. They're going to do all this. But they would not listen. They would not listen. The Bible tells us, again, the Bible tells us, it says, and they themselves what? Israel's request for a king was granted. And friends, if you know the Bible story, you know what happened to the children of Israel and what they went through under Saul. Saul would become the first king of Israel. Not because God intended it to be so, but because what? There was a house divided, a group of people divided, who did not want God to lead them anymore. Let us be quite clear, unbelievers. Let us be determined that as a church, it is not about us, but it's about God. Whatever we do in the church as always should be, am I glorifying God? Is this glorifying his kingdom? If someone was to show up in this church, will they say, "I'd like to join. I'd like Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Remember that, friend. God wants to use you. Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
And so wherever you are, let us serve God and let us seek God. Amen.
Amen.
And now let us pray for our church together. A church united. Let us begin. Loving God,
we pray for our church. In so unitedness, our community, our nation, and the world in this time of crisis. God of all comfort, we pray for those who have been, who are, and who will be affected by the whole and compassive COVID-19, the physical, the mental, spiritual, emotional, and financial burdens are great. Grant that we may come out of this crisis with open eyes, more fully available to the needs of those most vulnerable and in need. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. And now it is communion time. Oh yes, no, now it's prayer time. And then we'll go to communion. Amen.
Word, Lord Jesus, wherever there is no peace on earth, dream of us to, in our hearts, in our countries, Lord Jesus. Your banner is flying high, God. And Lord, we ask all these things in the mighty and precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Just body of Christ here to you, dying for you. And then, friends, let's sing and dream together the blood of Christ.
Thank you.